Hello and welcome to Alfons Zeilais. My name is Johanna Nagelsbach. I'm the grandniece of the painter Alfons Zeilais. The year is still 1912. Alfons Zeilais has finished working for the porcelain manufacture Nymphenburg and continues his studies at the Academy of Fine Arts in Munich. What is the situation in 1912? Let's take stock in this video.
Let us first look at the art world. As long as feudalism prevailed in Europe, nobody danced out of line. Art changed very slowly, according to the tastes of the nobility and the church, the main buyers of art. Art was taught at the state academies, which defined what art should be. With the growing democratic movement and the rise of an increasingly affluent middle class, other art movements were able to emerge. Art was no longer only in demand from the nobility and the church, but also from the middle classes. Impressionism emerged in France in the second half of the 19th century. At first, it was vehemently rejected, then increasingly accepted, and finally its paintings were traded at very high prices. The secessions were formed, the Munich Secession in 1892, the Vienna Secession in 1897 and the Berlin Secession in 1898, although these were soon no longer progressive enough for young painters. The Brücke was founded in Dresden in 1905 and the new Secession in Berlin in 1910. Both were naturally rejected by the existing Berlin Secession, just as the Munich Secession rejected the new Munich Artists Association founded in 1909. And the Blaue Reiter, founded in 1911. Despite existing for only a few years, the Blaue Reiter and die Brücke left their mark on the art scene in Germany. Parallel to this rapid development of art, new forms of art management became necessary. Artists were no longer made directors of art collections and looked after them, which meant that the collections were organized according to personal preferences. A gallery director should, as the Munich gallery director von Tschudi put it, convey aesthetic values that he carefully selects and presents in order to show the art of all times in its topicality. Great individual personalities characterize the development of the galleries of that time. Hugo von Tschudi in Berlin and Munich and Alfred Lichtwarck in Hamburg are great personalities who show that committed individuals can achieve a great deal. Both of them reorganized their galleries and continue to shape the art landscape in Germany up to today. Art is becoming international. There is also a lot of movement in other areas of art. Richard Wagner, the creator of a new kind of music drama, has already passed away. Schönberg characterizes modern music with his atonal compositions. Gerhard Hauptmann's novel Atlantis has just been published in 1912. Thomas Mann's Buddenbrooks, published in 1901, is widely read, and Hermann Hesse's Beneath the Wheel is already 6 years old. Karl May dies in Radebeul. In 1911, Marie Curie is awarded the Nobel Prize for Chemistry, making her the first person to win the Nobel Prize for the second time. From 1912, Lise Meitner works together with Otto Hahn at the newly founded Emperor William Institute for Chemistry in Berlin-Dahlem, where she researches radioactivity. The American composer Scott Joplin has already composed numerous ragtimes, including The Entertainer, and has just released his opera Trimonisha. Igor Stravinsky's ballet The Firebird celebrates its premiere in Paris and Franz Lehár's operetta Gypsy Love in Vienna. For the first time, an opera with the then world-famous tenor Enrico Caruso is broadcast to a small audience by radio from the Metropolitan Opera in New York. The Titanic collides with an iceberg and sinks. Over 1,500 people lose their lives. In 1912, the arts and sciences are flourishing. The economy had developed rapidly. Germany's total value added rises from just under 14.2 billion marks in 1870 to almost 48.5 billion marks in 1913. Germany has become a highly industrialized country. Industrialization has not stopped at German kitchens either. The housewife, which is still the norm, prepares lunch and dinner with a hurrah frying and baking appliance, which did all by itself, leaving her time to whip up a cake on the side with the original Plitz mixing bowl or the Suevia Duff mixing bowl. She whips the beaten egg whites for the cake and the cream with the American whisk bowl. The housewife no longer scrapes Spätzle by hand, but uses the original Hühnersdorf patent Spätzle mill. A modern class society has emerged in which the middle classes and the working classes live in sharply divided social worlds. Despite all the differences between the classes, nobody has to go hungry anymore. The unemployment rate is only 1-2%. It is very important to Emperor William II to integrate the workers into the young nation state of Germany and to allow them to share in the growing prosperity which succeeds in many areas despite all the tensions between the classes. European countries have divided up large parts of the world among themselves as colonies. Germany has only had a strong interest in colonies since Emperor William II. Emperor William II pursued a strong colonial policy for political reasons. In 1912, Germany was the third largest colonial power in terms of area, after Great Britain and France. However, German companies traded with the British colonies to a far greater extent than with the German colonies. However, Emperor William II increases the size of the fleet considerably in order to protect the German colonies. Britain feels provoked by the expansion of the German fleet. In the second Morocco crisis of 1911, Germany makes a clear threatening gesture against France and increasingly isolates itself. So, while culture and the economy were flourishing in 1912 and international trade flows were increasing, the political differences between the European nation states were also growing. If economic and cultural developments continue as they are in 1912, Alfons Zeilis should actually have an outstanding artistic career ahead of him.
Thank you for joining me in looking at the cultural and political environment in which Alfons Zeilis moved in the year 1912. In the next video, we will see how Alfons Zeilis develops. I look forward to seeing you again.